Wow. Cesar, good luck with Bob Ridley's classes after he sees this. You're going to have to take persuasion for the seventh time.
James Collins actually holds the record with 8, so Cesar has got another
something
one to
aim for.
Actually, that's the, I'm going to point out, that's actually the best Cesar has ever looked, I think. Oh. He looked pretty good. Better than normal. So.
And I know you were telling me when he was talking about Ozzy Osbourne, he bit off the head of a bat?
Yeah. Bit the head right off a bat, Ozzy Osbourne. Good stuff.
Good stuff. Well, you like the blood, so maybe...
Exactly. That's why I'd be a good vampire.
That is fun for you.
Yeah.
And Michael Jackson, come on now. He's a thriller. Doggone it.
Yeah, he thrills all right.
And I heard he beats it, too. Well, with that, we're going to send it to some more scary SSU places. Now with a little humorous twist.
Oh, yeah.
Some other stories that I've heard from some of the officers. One, some officers have been walking in the Fine Arts Building, especially in the upstairs late at night. All of a sudden, a water fountain will go off for no reason whatsoever. Not as in just the motor kicking in, as in water squirting out of it. For no reason whatsoever. The other story I had heard, one of our sergeants at the time had been walking there. There was a chair in the middle of the hallway. So he pushed it back. This was, 2, 3, 4 in the morning. So he pushed a chair from the middle hallway back around the side. Well, he'd gone in and he'd checked the upstairs penthouse in Fine Arts. Came back out. The chair was back in the middle of the hallway again. After that, we had a hard time getting him to go back into Fine Arts to check things again. So... those are stories I've heard about, and my own personal experience.
Wow, I can't imagine a chair moving like that.
I'm telling you, it's that Fine Arts Building. Scary things happen over there.
The editors in raw footage found that the chairs moved on them. As you can see, the four chairs go brown, orange, orange, brown. But when they walked in, it went brown, orange, orange, brown.
Scary stuff. Fitting for our Halloween episode.
Fine Arts, don't go there.
Take a look.
Back when the police department used to do the security out here, and there was still smoking allowed in the buildings back then, you could smoke in your office. They used to have an office over in the ST building. So one night, one of their officers was on rounds, making sure everything was locked up. Well, a couple of the other officers had snuck in and gotten one of the skeletons from, there's one over in PE 214 or 212 over in the PE building. They'd taken it back to the police department's office because they always went back there after rounds, set it up in the office, in the chair, smoking a cigarette. They hid like a couple offices down, heard the officer come walking down the hall, heard him open the door, slam the door shut, and walk back off.
Whoa, did you guys just hear that?
No.
That door over there.
I did not.
Point right there. I just door over there.
So did you make that up?
Yeah,
did you really hear
it? I mean, someone said they had a
those kids were
supposed to go on
there because I told them.
Back when the police department was here, but they had student security officers when I worked. They had turned off all the power and all the lights on campus, okay? That's just for routine maintenance to check all the relays and stuff. Well, we had one kid who completely refused to, wouldn't buy into any of the ghost stories, but he acted like he wasn't really quite sure. He just kind of, whenever we'd tell him something about over there. So we set him up. We had an individual go hide inside the theater, which was completely black. And we decided, okay, he was in the office. It was myself, this kid, and our boss at the time. So we had already stashed somebody in the theater. We go, well, why don't we go over and sit in the theater and see if anything happens? The kid goes, no, nothing's going to happen. No, nothing will happen. Yeah, let's go. So we went over there. We walked in the theater. Went down to the second or third row. I couldn't remember which. And... our buddy was right behind us, so we're all sitting there in the dark. After about 10 minutes, The guy who had been hiding in the theater reached up and grabbed his shoulder. Kid just went, ah! Ran out of the theater. We found him outside just going, did you guys feel that? And then he comes out and we're all going, yep, we did. So, yeah, we got the poor guy pretty good. I'm not above a practical joke once in a while. And I like to make sure my officers are checking and doing their penthouses like they're supposed to. Well, one night I had hid in the fine arts penthouse. You go in the second door in there, and you can hide right around the corner. I had a little chair. I was sitting there on a stool. I waited for 45 minutes. In the dark, nothing else. Nothing happened to me. I didn't hear anything strange or anything like that. All of a sudden, the officer comes walking in. I hear the door shut, feel the footsteps, and I grab their leg. I've never heard such a scream in my life. That poor officer went, ran out. Oh, he starts getting on the radio. Something's going on. And I come walking out going. And then after that, there were a few words that I can't repeat on television that would have come out.
Some pretty good stuff from Dave Hemp, Assistant Public Safety Director here at SSU.
You know, I'd have to say, remind me never to work campus security.
I know.
That is just cruel.
They've got about the worst job on campus.
No doubt. Well, you know, this has been a great Halloween episode, I might add. You look great as Underwear Zorro Man.
Thank you.
And
you look good as prostitute. Although, don't you dress like that at the bar? I couldn't really tell a difference, but...
Wow. I thought
it was pretty normal.
Thanks, Ryan. Oh, wow. We better cut this show off before Ryan gets a little out of control and Underwear Man gets really excited.
Yeah.
With now, we're going to go to some final fun.
Check it out.
Why?
Why TV?
Happy Halloween.
The foulest stench is in the air. The funk of 40,000 years. And grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. And though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver. For no mere mortal can resist. Ha 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 ha!